18. Joining now, though, is Clark Packard. He is a trade policy counsel at the R Street Institute, former financial services lawyer and budget policy advisor for former South Carolina Governor Nikki Haley. Great to have you on. Appreciate you coming on the show.
Thanks for having me.
So the big news, obviously, in the financial world, economic world, and in the news world as well, is President wanting these tariffs on aluminum and metal is being met with great resistance from conservatives more than anybody else. I know you're not exactly in favor of this. Why is this such a terrible thing? What's going to happen here?
Well, I think the first thing to do is look at the market's reaction. The Dow was down 500 points within a couple hours of the announcement and was down 420 points overall yesterday. You know, steel company stocks, yes, they were up, but car companies and users of steel were down. And, you know, look, tariffs are nothing more than taxes, right? This is basically just going to be a big tax increase on businesses that use steel and aluminum as inputs for their manufacturing and production. And so, you know, it might benefit in the short run domestic steel companies, but in the long term, I think it's going to do considerable damage to the overall underlying economy.
Is this a trade war that we're in right now, or is this just a trade fight that we're in?
I think that this is a more aggressive action than anything we've seen from the administration at this point. I mean, during the 2016 campaign, the president promised all this aggressive action, but that sort of got delayed because of the fight over tax cuts last year and, you know, their attempt at doing health care reform. But I think this may be the first shot in a ongoing back and forth sort of tit for tat with our trading partners.
I mean, I know the president has talked about for trade for a very long time, and some of the things he says certainly revs up a certain portion of his base. But so many people, even in the administration, some big names in the administration are against this. People who have advised him, Larry Kudlow, is out saying this could be a major calamity for the United States economy. Why does he want to do this? I mean, what's the benefit here? What is the president, do you think, hopes to accomplish by doing this?
I think, you know, like you mentioned, the president has been talking about this stuff. Actually, if you look at it, he's been talking about this since the 80s. At first, it was Japan that was sort of the boogeyman. But yeah, trade seems to be a long-held position, or sort of a hostility toward free trade has been a long-standing position of the president. And so, yeah, I mean, I think that he also views this as a political tool. Like you mentioned, it revs up factory workers in steel-producing companies, you know, in Northeast Ohio and Western Pennsylvania. But, you know, look, the manufacturing sector is growing right now at the fastest rate it has since 2004, and I'm really concerned that this could undercut that. At a time, again, when the economy is moving in the right direction.
All right. We're talking with Clark Packard, trade policy counsel at the R Street Institute, former financial services lawyer. What are the laws here regarding who has the power to do this? The president can just levy tariffs down. Congress doesn't have to have a say in any of this?
Well, this is an interesting case. Article 1, Section 8 of the United States Constitution gives the power to set tariff rates to Congress. However, Congress is free to delegate those powers to the executive branch. And so what sort of the legal authority here was a law known as the Trade Expansion Act that we passed back in the early 1960s, sort of the early stages of the Cold War. And basically what the law says is that if the Department of Commerce says that imports are jeopardizing our national security, then it's up to the president to announce a broad trade remedy to combat that threat. And that's what they invoked in this case. But I know there's a lot of hostility toward this in Congress. I mean, this really splits the Republican Party.
Yeah, absolutely. Great to have you on, Clark. I appreciate your time and your perspective.
Great. Thanks for having me.
I'm Clark Packard with the R Street Institute, former financial services lawyer and budget policy advisor to Nikki Haley, South Carolina Republican governor, who is ambassador to the United Nations. 812 on WBAL News Radio.